So congratulations.
This sonata is, as you know, one of the three last sonatas of Beethoven. And it's very profound, all three of them. It's a different way of human happiness, global happiness, and you can call individually what you want, but it's something much more profound than a joy of having a glass of champagne or so. And the color is very important in this piece, and I think you have the right color to play this very profound sonata, so congratulations. And you really follow very well all the nuances and everything that Beethoven has written. He was very precise in his writing and where the crescendo starts, where it goes, and it should be respected. So bravo for this as well. Very nice work. Since I cannot really approach you and I cannot really show you anything, it's a little hard, but let's speak about in general. You know that Beethoven always searched to grow himself and also to contribute to the growth of the musical world at that time. He was a thinker. He was living in the age of enlightenment, and it means that he wasn't happy of what he's getting now, but he always wanted to grow the possibilities, and this is why he contributed to create new pianos. So with Beethoven's time, the piano has developed because he has worked with piano builders. He was hearing sounds and possibilities well ahead. He was hearing orchestra, he was hearing string quartets, and he was not happy with this small instrument of 5.5 octaves. So he talked to the piano builder saying, I want this, I want this, how can you do that? And by the time he wrote those three piano sonatas, he couldn't hear anymore. But the possibilities of what one could make on the keyboard was so incredibly large. Not like the Steinway we're having now, but it was close to it. And he also used from the last note in the bottom to the last note in the top, he was hearing a big, big range. And a variety of song and large scale. And this should be very, very clear. Also, he was a very masculine composer. He was someone who really fought not for himself, but for the rightness of people, of the human being. So there is always this structure in his way of thinking, his philosophy, and he had also lots of sense of humor. So I'm not saying it should be metronomical and strict, but there is still some kind of very strong bone in the composition, and I think this should be respected as well. I found your opening was beautiful. It was full of heart and profoundness. But then when you start the theme, you know, the left hand, it's just harmonies and it's kind of moving. I don't know how you see the left hand. What the role of the left hand here for you? What is it?
I hear that this is like the string quartet, the bottom voice is like supporting, like, the blossoming of this warmth.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so it does, yeah, driving the harmonies, because it's very simple, the harmonies, and it's a simplicity that, yeah, it's to try to achieve that flow and being, I think, being expressive in the right hand, but not using rubato to shape the left hand has been what I've been working on.
Right, so we agree that the string quartet, when it's accompanying, it should be with full, like 100% playing, but it should be with the same spirit and intensity of being the main voice. It should be like quarter volume. So I felt that left hand was a little too dominant. It should be supporting. It's like when you're accompanying a singer, you should support, but you shouldn't be leading. You should be, even if you lead, it should be so delicately done that no one noticed. Mm-hmm. Can you try again this mm-hmm. passage? You see, for me, left hand is louder.
Yeah.
Can you play right hand alone? I think it's beautiful, and I'm sitting like 3 meters from you, but you are playing for the last seat in the hall. Mm. I can hear you, but barely, without the left hand. Can you try to do the same expression, with the same affection you're playing on every note? Do mi bemol, la bemol, la, sol, to the person sitting the last row of this hall. Go on. Very good. And can you now add the left hand? Can you play the left hand alone? Mm-hmm. Okay. Can you make a shape, and also is it possible for you to play legato, the last la da pa 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 to the next pa da 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 da, instead of making a breathing in between? Mm. Do you know what I mean? Mm. Between the harmonies, the yeah. harmony change, legato. Mm-hmm. Good. Go on. And bless. Very good. And now, do you think you can play louder than the three notes, especially when when there are three notes, you yeah. know, they're against one note.
Yeah.
So it should be even less. Can you try that? Mm. Very good. And now with the right hand. Right hand, more, yes, go, 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 yes, yes, that's much better, please work on this, mm-hmm. the left hand should be absolutely smooth, mm-hmm. it's very difficult, left hand is much more difficult than the right hand, mm-hmm. you know, you have to have the control of the bass ta and the so that it sounds very organic, you know, and not feeling any difficulties right. or no, and it should be legato between the harmonies. Mm. And for example, also at bar, you have bar numbers. You know what, maybe it's easier if I show you like this from here.
Yeah, I can see, yeah.
This, it's maybe the piano also. I only hear the crescendo in the bass, but not much of the climax on the right-hand side. Can you try again from wherever you're comfortable?
Sure.
Right hand alone. Mm-hmm. just make you a technical suggestion? You know that our fifth finger is smaller than all the other fingers, right? So you have to help the fifth finger, especially if they have to fight against all the trills. Try to play flat your fifth finger with all the weight of this meat you have. Try to put the weight, think that all of this is one finger, not this, because the poor thing is doing this, but it's so short and thin, you know? So imagine first, this is the entire hand is your finger, and then your forearm and all of this. Can you try again? Just don't do the da-ra-ran, but only do, do, he, ni bemol, fa. Can you try? Yeah, you see? This, yes, yes, yes. And try to keep it straight here. Yes, yes, yes. 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 Yes, and all the whole body, yes. You see? Can you hear the difference of the sound?
Yeah, yeah? Picture.
And so just very light, this drum, drum, and take your time to really put the weight as it's going higher and higher. Can you try? I know that it's a new thing, it's difficult to do. And just don't do the trills, but only the note. Fa, mi, do, re, re, do, mi. Contrary, the left hand, just put your finger. Don't put any weight on the left hand, so that it doesn't overpower the right hand. Straight arm, yes. Yes. And the rest, you know, this is the bone. And the rest is not so important. You know, the trill is just something to go. So very light, because it should not overpower. Otherwise, you know, you want to hear it, but then you don't hear it. So it's very important that you give the impression that it's going so wide and big. Yeah? And Beethoven, also you have to be flexible, of course. And you are allowed to be flexible, but sometimes it's important to keep some kind of pulse so that it gives more of power. More you have the pulse, more you have the impression of freedom. And when you hear great masters playing piano, or even singers, when they are free, you don't really hear where they are breathing or where they are taking time. So it's one of the most difficult things to do, but we all should aim to be free that no one else can hear that you're free. And then there is this excitement that comes. If you hear that, you know, oh, she wants to make a rubato here, there's a big, big breathing, and then a very nice shape here, you shouldn't hear that, you know? It should be so subtly done that you do it, but without noticing, and people will think, oh, this is so fantastic, why is it? So can you try again this?
Development.
Yes.
Thank you.
is a passage where it's just kind of always the same thing with different tonality. And very often in Beethoven, the end of the phrase is the beginning of the phrase. So this is a very exemplar passage where that's the end, but at the same time, it's the beginning of da 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 da. And what's important is the two first beat da 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 should be exactly on time, because it's the third beat da 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 that gives the indication where it goes da 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 the answer. So can you do it very strict? I know that it's not easy if you're used to do it differently, but can you try? Yes, clear. Clear direction. Crescendo. Diminuendo. Go, go. And crescendo, continue, continue. Continue. Yes, and you can make rubato here to prepare for that. You know, it should be always, you have to know where you go, and then it feels much shorter, this passage, and more dramatic.
Right.
Okay? And the rest is the same, and I also wanted to tell you, so please be careful about the second time when it comes back, it's the same, here, you know, with the right hand, please be careful. Can you do the coda? You can do a little bit before, it's maybe easier for you. Lots of notes from Beethoven here, right? It's one bar piano, crescendo, piano, crescendo, forte. I know it's difficult. But I would suggest, if I may, that when you enter this coda, to not to do a ritardando. Stay in tempo. You can start earlier if you want, from here. It goes here, to here, one thing, it's not a different thing. And then it starts from here. You think, and then Beethoven makes a wink, piano. It should be a surprise. In your head, you should think. It goes da 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 la, but then it's piano. Okay, you can start a little earlier. Take your time. Even bigger. Can you do this part? Sorry. This was good. This was very good. this was very good, and this was very good too, and this was very good.
Expand here.
Yes, really loud, and you can take your time. For the first time, you can take time here, mm-hmm. Okay? And also, sorry, this was very good, that was on time. The same, please, exactly on time. You take time here, mm-hmm. because it's a surprise to be piano,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
But here, you should take, you shouldn't take time, it should mm-hmm. be exactly on time again. This crescendo, also I don't know why you do the second da da. This is less. Is that on purpose or is that the piano?
I guess resolving note, the slur maybe.
Yes, no. It should, every note should be louder and louder.
Mm-hmm.